As mass shootings have sadly become more common, many of us have been forced to think about how we protect ourselves if we ended up in one of these dangerous situations. Andy Lightbody, a military and technology analyst, joins us live this morning. Good morning, Mr. Lightbody. We want to get right to it. Unfortunately, mass shootings have become a part of our lives. When we enter a space, what should we be paying attention to?
Just about everything. You know, you got the old adage, well, it can't happen to me, it can't happen here. Unfortunately, it has, and it continues to do exactly that. When you come into a place, obviously, you're going to look at the people that are around you. You're going to look at the circumstances where people are moving. Is someone acting weird? Is it really hot and somebody's wearing a trench coat? Your alert needs to go up. You also need to immediately start looking to say, I came in the front door. If I had to get out, where would I go? Is there side entrances? Is there back entrances? Is there a stairwell or is there a closet? All of these things that people just, we basically are in a green, very low alert mode most of the time. And unfortunately, we can see what the consequences are.
So you mentioned exits. They are key, but you might not be able to go out the way you came in. So how can you best plan your escape route?
Well, you know, if you're at a market or a school or a hospital or someplace that you're familiar with, it's kind of surprising to me that you don't look around well in advance. We're at the grocery store once or twice a week. Once we're there, you know, spend an extra minute, go walk around the perimeter of the place, see where there are side doors. Are there any windows? Is there some sort of an area that'll lead out to the loading dock? These are all of the kind of things that are very simple. They're not intrusive, and yet they're extremely helpful if you get into an emergency or a dangerous situation.
And it's always hard to know how we're going to respond. You have all that adrenaline rushing through you. We've heard in the past, run, hide, or fight. What should people do? How do you know what is the best reaction to have? And what action should you take when you first hear those sounds of gunfire or screaming?
Molly, you know, we're used to having certain noises around us all the time. If something is out of the ordinary, if you hear a big crash bang, like a display has been knocked over, if you hear those pops, it sounds like a firecracker, or obviously if there's an explosion, your immediate reaction, rather than to run, should be to drop, basically drop and cover until you can assess the situation, find out what happened, and then you can plan your route accordingly. Whether you're going to crawl out, whether you're going to grab somebody, lead them out. But your immediate reaction is hit the dirt.
Yeah, it's heartbreaking we're even having to have these conversations. We heard earlier in the morning from the grocery worker union saying they'd want armed guards at the stores. What do you think of this? Is this a deterrent?
It certainly is a deterrent. You know, the unfortunate part is it's not the way we're used to living our lives. In the old days, you rarely see it, you know, except a cop maybe walk by in front of the store. But unfortunately, nowadays, you know, post-pandemic, pent-up kooks, the actual threat, very real threat of terrorism. You still got to look out for yourself. And now, unfortunately, it appears like at schools, you've got armed guards. Is that going to become the social norm? Unfortunately, very possible.
Andy Lightbody, thank you so much for joining us.